is up, Grocknation. Welcome back to Grockstar ASMR. We are in the arcade tonight, and we have ourselves another fragrance video for the summertime. I hope everyone's doing awesome, staying safe during these unsafe times. Before we get started, I'd like to give a shout out to my LGBT viewers. Enjoy your month, Pride Month. You guys earned it. As well, guys, if you like the video, make sure to give it that thumbs up, as well as a sub if you're not subbed already. Subbing to the channel lets me know there are people that want to see more videos, more content, that they care to get notifications. Turn them on if you don't. And the likes really help the algorithm, so other people can find the videos. So this video tonight is going to be based on a summer aquatics. Beach fragrances. Not beach videos. I have a lake video here for you right away, but these are going to be fragrances that you can wear out in the ocean, out in the lake, a day for drinks with friends at the lake, these kind of situations. Before we get into it, I want to give you guys an idea of what my ideal lake weekend slash day would be in a very relaxing setting. So, what I want is for you guys to sit back, relax, close your eyes, and enjoy the next few minutes as I describe to you what I believe to be the most relaxing summer weekend or day for me personally. I really hope you guys enjoy. So, the perfect summer day, or maybe weekend for me, up around 10:30, get up and have some breakfast, go outside and maybe hop on my riding mower and do my lawn. By this time it's about 11 a.m. so it's socially acceptable to mow your lawn in the neighborhood without disturbing the neighbors. I'll do my front yard and then my massive backyard. When that's done, I load up the truck with some swimming gear and stuff for the lake, as well as my dog, and we'll drive out to my cabin, which is on a provincial park about 20 kilometers out of town. Drive all the way there listening to my favorite summer songs with my sunroof down and my two windows of my Toyota Tacoma. So there's a nice big breeze coming through the truck for me and the dog. And we make our way to the cabin. I drop the dog off at the cabin. And I change into my swimwear. I make my way down to the dock, along with my kayaking life jacket. And I launch my kayak off the dock. I make my way to my favorite island on the lake. Out of the many islands on this awesome lake, this one has a sand beach, so I kayak directly to it. It takes about 15 minutes, listening to the wind blowing on the lake around me, the trees rustling, hot summer sun shining down on me. More times than not, there are otters on that lake that will pop up. As I kayak by, I can hear the sounds of all the other people's cabins doing yard work, mowing lawns, replacing decks, whatever it may be. I can hear the occasional car down the cabin road, and the occasional bus. Once I have the kayak rested nicely on the beach, I make my way just a little bit into the shoreline where I have a hammock I keep hung up, along with my life jacket. I also bring off bug spray, repellent, lotion. Strings attaching the hammock to the trees, because like most lake islands, this island is infested with ants and spiders and every other little insect you can imagine. So I shake out the hammock that inevitably has some in there, and I lay in the hammock and relax. The lotion on the strings keeps them from climbing onto the hammock. I play some relaxing music on my iPhone, and I read a book off of my iReader. On my iBooks, rather, on my iPhone, the app, while listening to this nice music. Satellite by BT is a favorite of mine for this particular spot. As I lay there and rock slowly in the wind, I can hear the boats going by, the trees rustling. Populated with pine mostly and some spruce, and the spruce that is a bit above my hammock kind of lets some sunlight flicker down on me in the shaded area I chose. After about 40-45 minutes, I get out of the hammock and make my way back to the beach, where I have a nice relaxing swim to cool off on that hot summer day. It feels nice to soak all the way up to my neck and just lay and float on that nice isolated beach. The lake looks almost like a mirror. It's so calm. I can see all the dragonflies gobbling up all the mosquitoes. Black flies and deer flies that are flying above the water. I soak like this for 15 minutes or so, and then I get out. And before I leave, there is almost like a rock wall that extends out into the water next to the beach. I do my traditional cannonball off of that right before I leave. Out back from my dock, this time a little closer to the shore. The island's closer to the shore, so I can see the work everyone else on this lake road is doing to their cabins. I wave at people in their backyards. People on boats wave at me as they drive by and try not to give me massive waves. I make my way back to rack and make my way back to the cabin. There I grab my dog and drop off my life jacket. I head back down to the dock after retrieving my dog's life jacket from my truck. I put his life jacket on, and the two of us enjoy a swim at the dock for around half an hour, 45 minutes. Just me and him playing. He has a really fun little floating frisbee he loves, and I just love throwing it in the water and watching him dive in after it, swimming out to grab it and bringing it back to me. This is his favorite place in the whole world. It is around this time that my fiance makes her way and she makes her way down to the dock to join us. She brings with her two towels and her swimsuit. She joins us in a swim, and afterwards we lay the towels down on a dock, and myself and her enjoy the sun and try to catch a tan, listening to the sounds of the lake, while my dog lays beside us drying off in the hot sun. When we are done this, the three of us make our way back up to our cabin, and we dry off with our towels, because you don't go back to the cabin after suntanning for that long without doing one more dip. We dry off, and we lay in our bedroom, with the curtain pulled down, three quarters on the window, so just a bit of sunlight shines in with the window open. And me, her, and our dog have a nap for around an hour, hour and a half, right before supper. And then we make our way, myself, her, and a dog in our truck. We make our way to the marina, where there's a bar and grill right on the edge of the lake, with an ice cream shop attached inside. We go here and we leave our dog in a truck with the windows open, because he doesn't jump out and no one's going to steal our vehicle. This is a close-knit community and everyone knows each other. So we head into the restaurant, bar and grill. We sit out on a patio overlooking the marina, where everyone from the lake and from town that brought their boats out are launching their boats from the boat launch, or just taking it out from their rented dock space. We sit out on this nice deck overlooking that beautiful lake, and depending on what day of the weekend this is, depends on what meal I will get. A cabin burger with some home-cut fries on a Friday, or a full rack of barbecue ribs on Saturday, as they are half price, with mashed potatoes and mixed vegetables. I sit and relax with a nice ice-cold beer. Grockstar is my favorite for this particular meal. It always has been. They frost the cups so nicely, and it is ice, ice cold. When we are done eating, we go to the ice cream shop attached to the bar and grill, and we get a couple of ice creams. We go and retrieve our dog from the truck, and we sit on one of the benches overlooking the lake, and the three of us sit and relax while we eat our ice cream and watch everyone out at the marina, including geese with their baby goslings, no more than 20 feet away from us. There's always a little school of them there every summer. Get into the truck, and we make our way back to the cabin, where we watch a movie with some popcorn. Fittingly, we watch a horror movie, as you do when you stay in a cabin. When we are done the movie, we make our way to bed, where we have hot, sweaty summer sex, and lay afterwards with just a sheet to cover, with the window open and the fan going. On a perfect, perfect night, there is a light thunderstorm outside and some showers, something that is not uncommon for our summers. And we go to sleep to the sounds of the rain Costco mule if I'm up to it. And then I head back inside and relax and enjoy the rest of the evening at home with my fiance. And that is my ideal summer weekend / day. I'm fortunate enough to have that happen about 5 or 6 times a summer, which is pretty great considering I don't get much of a summer at all. Really relaxing, isn't it? Yeah. If you were to bump into me that weekend at any time, there's a really, really good chance that I'm going to smell like one of these next 5 fragrances I'm going to go over, because I like to have my fragrances, my scents, fit the season and fit the occasion. These ones definitely do. So let's go over our very first fragrance in this list. I want to get it out of the way now because it's already made a few lists and you guys have seen it already. This one is the classic from Dolce & Gabbana. It is light blue intense. Light blue intense is a fragrance that came out during this boom of fragrances that started about 2010 all the way up to 2019. A huge influx of fragrances from the designer houses came out, and some of them are classics that I think will be timeless. This is one of them. This came out in 2017, towards the end of this big boom, but it is very awesome. It is an awesome aquatic. It's a unique aquatic in that it can be worn away from the lake in the summer months because it's so fantastic and so summery. It's a mood changer as well. If you want to set people in a summery mood, remind them that it is summer, this fragrance will do it for you. Very, very citrusy, and it's got some musk in it and some sandalwood. Oh, smells so good. Let's go over the notes for this fragrance for you guys. The nose behind this is Alberto Morales. The top notes are grapefruit and mandarin. The middle notes are seawater and juniper. And the base notes are musk and amberwood. So very woody, aquatic. It smells absolutely great. It smells like the summer. And this would be really, really fitting if you were going to spend a day at the lake, at the beach, even if you don't get in the water. This is really going to set that mood. But like I said, unlike most of the rest, this one can be worn outside the water as well. There's 2 of them in here. I would suggest not doing. This one for sure. It's a phenomenal choice for the summertime. This one, as well as 3 of the others. You gotta be careful with this purchase because it's a summer fragrance, exclusively a summer. You can't wear this in a winter. It would smell strange. You're gonna always say, what the fuck do you mean? It smells strange, Grock. Trust me on this. Once you smell this, you realize this cannot, should not be worn outside of the summer months. But yeah, that is Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue Intense. So the next fragrance we're going to talk about is probably the most aquatic fragrance you'll ever smell. This fragrance came out in 2008. It's one of the older ones out of this list. But it's also one of the most unique and one of the most situational. This fragrance is a great summer fragrance, but it's strictly aquatic. It's the most aquatic of all of these. You'll know if you ever smell it. This fragrance is Aquamarine by Bulgari. It's a weird shaped bottle. It's shaped like a pill. Spray it from up here. This fragrance, it smells smelling ocean would smell. You could smell that salt water, and it just smells, oh, it smells so fresh. I would recommend this any day you're going to go to the beach to go swimming. Again, a fragrance like this is not going to be waterproof, obviously, but after your swim, apply some of it on you, wander around the beach. I would absolutely recommend this for anyone that is a lifeguard at a beach, whether it be a lake or a ocean, preferably an ocean, but you can pull it off on a lake too. This would be an awesome, awesome fragrance, and it would fit so well. It is purely, purely an aqua fragrance. So, yeah, it's going to be very sweet. It's going to be very, very aquatic. Like, I don't know how else to say it. It smells like seawater. Let's go over the notes for this particular fragrance. Aquamarine by Bulgari came out in 2008. The nose behind it is Jacques Cavalier. The top notes are grapefruit, neroli, mandarin orange, and pétagrain. The middle notes are water notes, seaweed, and rosemary. The base notes are Virginia cedar and amber. So yeah, a very, very, very aquatic fragrance. This is super situational for me. I've had it since the end of last summer, and I haven't, look how much I've used. It hasn't been a lot, because it's very situational. This isn't something where I'll apply it while I'm going to work. I don't think I've ever worn this to work, unlike most of my other fragrances. This is one where I wear exclusively when I go to the lake. This, out of all these, is the likeliest one you'll find when I go and I lounge at a beach. For sure, this one here. That is Aquamarine by Bulgari. A very, very good choice if you're going to spend a day at the beach and you're just going to hang there all day, or you're going to work there. Awesome, awesome choice. When I say work there, guys, I mean like actually work at the beach, not at a lounge or a restaurant there. The next fragrance I'm going to show you is one that you would like to wear in a situation like that. So this next fragrance is by Armani. It is a flaker to the very, very successful Acqua di Gio. The most famous of them all, obviously, is Profumo. This one came out in 2018. I bought this the year it came out. I remember sampling it actually at the local drugstore, and I was like, wow, that really does smell like an aquatic version of Acqua di Gio. It's aqua is Acqua di Gio is this one. It really, something about it really does it for me. The fragrance I'm talking about is Acqua di Gio Absolute. It's got the gold juice. It's got like a little cork for a lid to let you know this is a beach aquatic type fragrance. It's listed as an aromatic fragrance, not an aquatic. But once you smell this, you'll know there are sea notes in here. Damn. This is a fragrance where if you were to work at a, I don't know, like a beach hut cocktail bar as a bartender, this is like what I would wear if I was doing that job. It's sexy, but it's still very aquatic, and you know, like you're working on a beach or you're at a beach restaurant lounge. If someone wearing this is serving you, it fits the mood. Let's go over the notes. So it was launched in 2018. The nose behind it is Alberto Morales, which I'm pretty sure he's the one that also did Profumo. The top notes are sea notes, bergamot, pear, grapefruit, apple, and lemon. The middle notes are lavender, geranium, and rosemary. The base notes are woody notes, tonka bean, patchouli, amberwood, and latiman. So yeah, a very fresh, aquatic fragrance, but very fittingly for the beach. This is a beach one. For sure. You could pull this off maybe the marina I was talking about out at our cabin. This, you might be able to pull this off there, but I think one of these other fragrances you want to mention would be a better choice. This is like a sexy waiter. That sexy waiter that's serving you is wearing this. This is what I picture when I think about that. Yeah, that sexy, muscle-headed douchebag smells like this. This is what I pictured as. But yeah, that's Grignaggio Absolute. A really, really great choice. Alright, so this next one is one we talked about earlier. By meaning in another video, we talked about the original of this. This is a flaker. This is a fragrance from the John Varvatos house, which again, like last time we talked about the original, red flag, I know. But the deal with the summer aquatics, aromatic summer beach fragrances are, you can't expect them to last a long time because they have the ingredients in them that just don't last. They're too fresh, they're too, not spicy, but like the projection's too crazy on them. And they got those aquatic notes, and it just, there's no fragrance you'll have, you know, like, this is probably the best performing fragrance of all of these ones I have here, but the rest of them, they're only going to last maybe 4 or 5 hours, including this one, which is why I included it in the list, and I love this fragrance. This fragrance is by John Varvatos, and it is Artisan Aqua. Look at that bottle. So this fragrance came out in 2013, and it is a direct flaker to the original Artisan, also by John Varvatos. They have a very, very similar weave. This one's got it covering entirely, and this one I always kind of feel is kind of like a flask. It's a very, very cool design. If you're into collecting fragrances, this fragrance smells amazing, and this bottle, honestly, for displays, looks awesome. It's got a little metal tag here. It looks like a flask, you know what I mean? Like, but it smells, this one to me smells like a jungle beach, or like a destination beach vacation, like a Cuba, a Mexico, a Costa Rica. In 2018, when I went to Kauai, I wore both of these exclusively. I wore them every day. I kept them in a truck, you know, because it shitty for me when I was in Kauai. The entire week I was there, the sun shone for 2 days. There was colossal rain there that you could Google about. If you Google the colossal rainfall in Kauai that sunk some of the island, Grock was there that week. Everyone there was like, oh, you guys are kind of lucky to witness something like this. Something like this doesn't happen. It happens once every 400 or 500 years. I'm like, no, I don't consider myself being lucky. I came here to drink beer and relax on a beach. But regardless, this is what I wore. And again, like I said, fragrances are memory capsules. They are memory capsules. This fragrance will always remind me of when I proposed to my fiance. I proposed to her on the Kalalau Valley Trail. Kalalau Valley in Kauai, if you're not familiar, is the aerial shot in a helicopter on Jurassic Park when they fly into the island on multiple Jurassic Parks. That's the Kalalau Valley. We went on a mountain hike, and I soaked myself in this because I knew he'd be sweating. I applied most of it on my clothes, and I wanted to make sure he smelled like this when we got to the end. So she knows, man, when I wear this, she knows, she smells it, and she goes, oh, that reminds me of Kauai. It's an awesome, awesome smelling fragrance. Whew, fucking so sexy, you guys. Let's go over the notes. This was launched in 2013. The nose behind it is Rodrigo Flores Row. I'm not sure if I butchered that name or not. The top notes are pomelo, mandarin orange, mastic or lentis, and cladium and angelica. The middle notes are palomarosa, lavender, toscanel, clary sage, and geranium, basil, jasmine, sambac, and coriander. The base notes are fir resin, musk, and patchouli. So, a common theme we're finding with these aquatic/beach fragrances, a lot of them have that mandarin orange on the opening. At least 3 of these 4 we looked at it has that. So that's something, right? Like, again, you want that fresh, almost like fresh squeezed fruit kind of deal. A banana, for example, or a pear, in my opinion, wouldn't be very tropical. You know, pineapple, grapefruit, mandarins, these kind of things, they're going to pop. And yeah, it's going to remind you of being at the beach. This is a great fragrance, like I said, for a destination trip. I would pack this. We're going to, hopefully, fingers crossed, we got both our shots. Things lighten up with COVID here. And the new year, we unpacking this bad boy when we go, as well as the main John Fervatos artisan. This is one of those ones where the Flaker is as good as the original, in my opinion. And again, they're very sentimental to me. Trash performance, but very, very good for its for what it does. Obviously, it's not a Flaker. This is a Flaker as well, of Aqua Di Gio. And the next one, actually, is a Flaker as well. So yeah, there's three Flakers here. That the original was not meant to be aquatic, but it made an aquatic Flaker, and it works. So this next fragrance you're going to look at is the cheapest of all of these fragrances. If you're on a budget, if you're thinking, Grock, I'm going to the beach, or I got a job at the beach, but I'm not making a lot of money. These fragrances are nice, but they're all about $80 to $100. The John Fervatos's aren't. The John Fervatos's are the second cheapest, but this one is your cheapest. You will get this for about $50 Canadian. The fragrance I'm talking about is Mont Blanc Legend Spirit. Legend Spirit is the flanker to the original Mont Blanc Legend. The original Mont Blanc Legend came out in 2011, right around the time, all those fragrance houses, designer houses, went crazy with fragrances. And this one, Flaker, came out in 2016. This is a unique fragrance we're going to talk about right here out of this list, because out of all of this list, this is the only one that could be worn year-round, and it fits the aquatic list as well, which is strange, because none of the rest of them are. This does, because this is a fresh fragrance. It's aquatic, but it's fresh. Remember, fresh, guys, is in year-round. This technically could be a signature fragrance. Very fresh with a hint of aquatic. This is extremely well for the beach, for the pool. And it's really, really well for working out. This is my go-to workout fragrance. I went for a run with my dog last Sunday, and I applied this on myself, on my clothes, and yeah, it smells so good. I went to a Subway after a long run. I think we ran 4 kilometers. And yeah, I smelled fresh when I got the Subway despite sweating my ass off. I shouldn't say run, jog, I guess. I started with sprint intervals, and eventually I just went down to jog intervals, and then jogging, and then speed walking towards the end. It was rainy and humid, and I'm really happy I was able to pull it off, but I wore this. So yeah, a very, very unique member of this list, but a part of this list nevertheless, because you can pull this off at the beach. You can pull this off at the pool, like I said. It's really great for like summer, maybe summer hot tub parties, summer pool parties. This would be a really good choice, and this won't break the bank. Like I said, you can get this for about 50 Canadian. Sorry, 60 Canadian, 50 US. There we go. Let's go over the notes of this one. So this fragrance came out in 2016. The top notes are grapefruit, bergamot, and pink pepper. The middle notes are water notes, lavender, and cardamom. The base notes are white musk, white woods, cashmere wood, and oak moss. So yeah, again, those aquatic fruits. Grapefruit again, another one. Grapefruit, pineapple, mandarin orange. Yeah, they're very, very tropical. And yeah, this is an aquatic version of this right here. But this, like I said, is a lot more fresher. Whereas this is somewhere in between Aqua Di Gio and Bleu de Chanel without the performance, though. This doesn't have the performance of the rest. This is actually, I believe this is a cologne. This comes in parfum, but no, this is the toilette, okay? So yeah, it don't matter, the toilette, the cologne, but this one, they don't last too long. I actually wore this to work 2 weeks ago, and I think it stayed on my skin for about 6 hours, and it was on my clothes for about 8. The same goes for this. But yeah, okay, Legend Spirit. But that's going to be it, guys, for this list. I never put a video out for about a week now, which is the longest I've gone. Been very, very busy, guys. I was ill again from that COVID shot, my second COVID shot. I'm really glad I got it, though, got that out of the way. I have another video planned out. Hopefully I'm going to get out to guys this week is an awesome roleplay video. I got some props even I ordered off Amazon. I'm really looking forward to it. And I also want to put out another spooky stories. I feel there's a group of people that like to watch them. And again, guys, if you like these kind of videos or you want to see certain type of videos, just let me know. If I know there are people that want to watch them, I will make the content. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really hope you guys have a fucking awesome summer. I'm so looking forward to it after this shitty winter of COVID. And yeah, everyone stay safe.